Hi, welcome all of you for another session from the series of Management Principles from Bhagavad Gita. Now this session is on goal setting, creating a direction in life. Goal setting. We all of us, we know that if there is no goal in life, no goal means no direction in life. And when there is no direction in life and you are already running in a multiple directions, where do you end up? Nowhere. An envelope which is going to somebody's address and you are sending an envelope from courier without address, where does it go? There is a huge size of ship, but it doesn't have a rudder which gives the direction to the ship. So a ship without a rudder, where does it go? It doesn't go anywhere. So there are a lot of people on this planet Earth who are doing a lot of hard work. There was a survey done by Yale University. And the survey was about how many people in the metropolitan, cosmopolitan cities do they really have a goal in life? You will be surprised to know that only 2% people on this planet Earth have clear defined goals. The rest are either having some dreams or living a clueless life. But does that mean they're not working hard? They're working very hard. They're working very hard, but they're not working smart. They're running very fast. But what's happening? End of the day, they don't know where have they reached and which direction are they running in. Many times we ask this question to people, what is more important, doing the right things or doing things rightly? So almost in every training program, we see a lot of people telling us doing things rightly is more important than doing the right things. Now, that's the catch. If you pick up a wrong thing, no matter how rightly you continue doing a wrong thing, you end up reaching a wrong place. If you do a wrong thing fast, you end up reaching a wrong place faster. So what's important is to pick up the right thing and then do it rightly. If you're running in a wrong direction, aapki disha hi galat hai, dasha kitni bhi achhi ho, no matter how hard you continue running in a wrong direction, you end up reaching a wrong place very fast. So in this regard, we have picked up chapter number 2, verse number 41 of Bhagavad Gita, very important shloka. In the beginning of Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna is directionless. Krishna is giving him direction. Krishna is acting as a mentor, a guide, a counselor, a coach, a teacher to Arjuna in Bhagavad Gita. We need a coach and we have to become a coachee. We all need a counselor, we have to be a counselee. We all need a clear mentor and we have to become a mentee. So let's see how Krishna is acting as a coach, counselor, guide or a mentor in our life. Krishna explains in this shloka very powerful. You like it. Open this shloka later on when you pick up a Bhagavad Gita. Chapter number 2, verse number 41. Vyavasaya atmika buddhi ekah kuru nandana. Let me chant the shloka first. Vyavasaya atmika buddhi ekah kuru nandana. Bahushakha hi anantascha buddhayo vyavasayinam. Vyavasaya atmika buddhi ekah kuru nandana. Let's pick up the first line. Vyavasay, Atmika, Buddhi. Three words. I'll repeat. Vyavasay, Atmika, Buddhi. Three words. Vyavasay is your duty. I am a trainer. So Vyavasay is a trainer. Atmika is Vivek Bindra. Vyavasay, Atmika, Buddhi. Ekah Kuru Nandana. Hey Kuru Nandan, Arjuna, become one with your duties and responsibilities, become focusedly focused. So what does this mean? Vyavasaya is your duty responsibility. For a teacher, there is a different vyavasaya. For a lawyer, different vyavasaya. Student, a different vyavasaya. So vyavasaya and you yourself, Atmika, Vivek Bindra. Vyavasaya, trainer, Atmika, Vivek Bindra. Ekaha! Only one direction for a devotee of Lord. Devotion is vyavasaya and the devotee is Atmika. So devotion and devotee become one, only one. Now, catch is, Krishna doesn't say dvau, trai, chatur, panch. He says ekah. So become one. That's called when you are looking at your goals so clearly, so focusedly focused, then the results are ought to come. Results are bound to come. It's a byproduct of your focus. Bahu shakha hi anantascha. If you've got a multiple branch intelligence, cut them off. Now those people, while being focusedly focused towards their key result area, towards the action plan, MAP, MAP. You know the MAP? Massive action plan. When they've got a massive action plan, and at that time they're thinking about multiple other things in relationship to their sense gratification. Aaj barish ho rahi hai, chalo parathe kha ke aate hain Murthal mein. Aaj barish nahi ho rahi hai, chalo parathe kha ke aate hain Murthal mein. You know, and there are people who are becoming so engrossed in any desire that is coming and they're ready to fulfill it. So they're not controlling the mind, mind is controlling them. You know, have you heard people saying, ye man ka raja hai, jo man ki kehta hai, ye wo karta hai. To ye man ka raja nahi hai, man ka gulam hai. Jo jo man ne kaha, isne wo sab kiya. That means he's not the master of mind, the mind has become his master. And that's a very dangerous situation. Why? Because your mind will keep giving you instructions. And if you follow all the dictations of your mind, you might end up reaching at a wrong place. Why? Because that was not in relationship to your key result area. So therefore, vyavasaya atmika buddhi ekaha, only in one direction. When you've got that kind of a focus, when you've got that kind of a concentration and perseverance, with lot of hard work, sincerity, focusedly focused, you clearly get results. But the moment you think about 100 other things in relationship to your multiple enjoyments while not being focusedly focused, what's happening? You tend to go downward into your integrity syndrome. And you know what's a downward integrity syndrome? The downward integrity syndrome is, let us say, if you need to give 100% in your project, in your key result area, and you give only 90% next time, what will happen? This time you've given 90%, you've lapsed only 10%, but next time you'll go further down and you will only give 90% of that 90%. That may be something around 80%, but next time you'll give only 80% of that remaining 80%, you'll further go around 60, and then next time 60% of that 60%, you'll further going down and down and down. This is how our focus goes down. Now here, once Dronacharya also took Pandavas and Kauravas for an outbound training program. And he took them to maybe Jim Corbett Park or Rishikesh or Manesar, I don't know where did he take them. But that was a jungle. And in jungle he was explaining them, teaching them military arts. And in military arts, he had put a wooden bird on the tree. And he said, we are going to aim at the eye of that wooden bird. He said, Duryodhan, uthao dhanush lagao baan, batao tumhe kya dikhta hai. Gurudev, mujhe ped dikh raha hai, aur kya dikhta hai. Gurudev, mujhe chidiya dikh rahi hai, aur kya dikhta hai. Gurudev, mujhe patte bhi dikh rahe hai. Shabash, very good, stand here. And then, who comes? Yudhishthir, uthao dhanush lagao baan, batao Yudhishthir, tumhe kya dikhta hai, Gurudev, mujhe bhi ped dikh raha hai. चिड़िया दिख रही है, पत्ते दिख रहे हैं, शाबाश तुम भी खड़े हो जाओ. अब भीम, भीम तुम्हें क्या दिख रहा है, उठाओ धनुष लगाओ बाण, गुरुदेव मुझे आम दिख रहे हैं. नाउ दिस इज कॉल्ड सिलेक्टिव वॉचिंग. और क्या दिख रहा है, गुरुदेव मुझे बहुत भूख लग रही है, मुझे बहुत सारे आम दिख रहे हैं. और क्या दिख रहा है, गुरुदेव मुझे केवल आम ही दिख रहे हैं, क्या मैं आम तोड़ के लाऊं आपके लिए भी. नाउ अ मैन who thinks about multiple other things, can he get success? Can he actually hit the bullseye of his goal? And comes Arjuna. Arjun, uthao dhanush, lagao baan, batao tumhe kya dikh raha hai, Gurudev, mujhe chidiya ki aankh dikh rahi hai. Aur kya dikh raha hai, Arjun, mujhe keval chidiya ki aankh dikh rahi hai. Aur kya dikh raha hai, Arjun, Gurudev, mujhe keval chidiya ki aankh hi dikh rahi hai. Arjun, main tumhara guru, tumhare samne khada hu, kya tumhe main dikh raha hu? Nahi Gurudev, mujhe aap nahi dikh rahe, mujhe keval chidiya ki aankh dikh rahi hai. Shabash Arjun, chalao teer and thak the bird's eye. That's called vyavasaya atmika buddhi ekaha kuru nandana, only in one direction, and then you're bound to get right results in life. Now people who have multiple other desires, that's fine, but regulate them. You know, once you're able to regulate them, tolerate them, and remain focused, your emotional intelligence score also goes up. So Krishna gives very powerful teachings in Bhagavad Gita. That's called setting a goal. Of course, that was only the first part of goal setting. We'll also cover second part of goal setting. Keep watching our videos and we'll be happy to serve you. Thank you.